Xiaomi's version of Android 15, aka HyperOS 2.0, is officially here for global Xiaomi devices, and I just got it a couple days ago on my Xiaomi 14T Pro. Even though I had a lot of good things to say about HyperOS 1.0, especially the lock screen designs and the animations, I also had a lot of complaints about it, including consistency, background app management, and missing key features. It was still 1.0, so I did give HyperOS a bit of a break, but it's been a year and it is now 2.0, so this time we're going to look at it a little closer. So let's go over everything that's new and see if some of these issues have been fixed. Let's start right at the top with all the beautiful new lock screen templates with new effects and layout options. I already love the ones on 1.0, but these new ones look even better. I love this new one with a glowing textile clock with a subtle date in the upper right corner, really cool attention to detail, but even better are the new scenery wallpapers with more interactive depth effects. I really love this Windows XP-esque wallpaper and this cloudy mountain. They both have this surreal Studio Ghibli feel to them, which is super attractive. There's also this new section for Eastern aesthetics, which are also nice if you're looking for more of a flowery type of feel. And for all these, the always-on display syncs with the clock design, so the transition is super smooth and seamless. Speaking of which, the transition effects and the animations have also seen some noticeable changes. There are big, full-screen animations for everything you do on screen. It does give a smoother vibe and subtle haptics for almost every single interaction, but I will say it's a lot, maybe a little too much. Every square or UI element is animated with some exaggeration, even when pulling down the notification shade, going to the quick panel, or charging your phone. It looks nice, but I feel like it slows things down a tiny bit because you have to wait for the animation or the transition to finish. That said, I really like the slightly improved app opening animations. It feels even better when opening each and every app. The home screen here has also seen a bit of an update. When going into the edit view, you get this sort of helpful app grid that helps a ton in organizing your home screen, so you'll know if there's a space for a row of app icons or a widget in these spaces. It's just a lot more user-friendly when personalizing your home screen. What has seen a bit of a downgrade is the scaling. Just like before, you get either 4 or 5 icons in a row. The standard 4 icon format is fine, but the denser format now makes the icons so much tinier compared to before. There's really no default way to fix this. I even had to hide the app name labels so it doesn't look so cramped. So this part definitely needs a fix, or I hope Xiaomi can add an option to reduce the number of rows so the dense format can scale properly. Some of the stock apps have seen some visual updates. The format of the weather app is still the same, but it does have nicer animations and the UX changes to match the weather conditions of your location, which is really cool. The calendar app is a bit more user-friendly, now with the 3 different view options at the bottom bar here for easy access. The clock app is just slightly different, but I think it looks less systematic and fits the general HyperOS look a little better now. For gaming, Game Turbo now has a few extra settings, including this wild boost mode, which improves performance by pushing the thermals and eating up more battery. You have some additional control over the visuals too, so you can customize how you want to experience your gameplay. The settings menu also got a bit of a revamp. It's basically the same, but it's got these outlines now, which make it look very iOS-y, but I'm not totally against that. One thing that hasn't really changed is the default ringtones and alert sounds available. Of course, you can just download a new one from the store, but I wish Xiaomi had some better ones, especially for notification sounds. It's 2025, so of course AI is a big newsmaker, but for the global version of 2.0, there's really not that much, to be honest. Everything from Circle to Search to Photo AI editor tools were already available through OTA updates during HyperOS 1.0, so there really isn't anything new other than the fact that Xiaomi phones pretty much have all the features that the other OEMs do too. Speaking of which, there's still a lot of features that I consider are missing on the global version of HyperOS compared to competitors like One UI. I already talked about this on my 1.0 video, but custom automations are still missing here. It is available on the Chinese version of HyperOS, but it's still not available on the global version. I consider modes and routines to be pretty essential when using my Samsung phones, so I do wish that kind of feature moves on over to HyperOS. Another huge feature that's not here on the global version is Xiaomi's HyperConnect framework, which on Chinese Xiaomi phones basically connects the huge bridge between macOS and Xiaomi phones and tablets. So with that installed as an app on your Mac, you can mirror your phone screen, clipboard syncing for cross-device copy and paste, and share files. For someone like me who uses an Android phone and a Mac together, that is a huge feature to bridge the gap between the two. So when or if it does come over to global markets, I'm going to have a hard time staying away from Xiaomi phones. Besides those things, Xiaomi did make a ton of under-the-hood optimizations to improve the general day-to-day experience. One of my big complaints about HyperOS was the memory management, which is apparently improved with the new dynamic memory system, which allows better resource allocation so that apps start up faster. I'm actually already seeing the positive results. Even after I've closed the app for my recent apps, I noticed the relaunch times have been significantly improved. You don't have to stare at a splash screen for a long time. The OS is better at remembering what you were doing before in the app, and it feels like it's just resuming it, which is a lot more seamless. Xiaomi also claims to have upgraded their rendering for graphics and for multitasking, so the internals are better at handling the graphical components of the software, and having a lot of apps open or multitasking is supposedly less taxing on the battery. In actual experience, I haven't seen much of a boost in terms of battery life. Maybe I just need more mileage on it, but I don't expect a huge boost in screen on time or anything like that. But I have noticed there are a lot less performance hiccups. So things are a lot more consistent in my day-to-day usage, which addresses one of my main concerns with HyperOS 1.0. So all in all, while changes here for the global version of HyperOS 2.0 seems more like version 1.5, I really do like some of these much needed improvements, especially in terms of the general day-to-day performance and memory management for background apps. I like all the little tiny visual tweaks they did in small areas, which shows good attention to detail. Some of the new animations seem unnecessary, but I'm not totally against it since things do seem smoother overall. The only thing that really needs to change is all the missing features that are only available on the Chinese versions of these Xiaomi phones. I really won't have much complaints once those things start to come over to the global versions. Okay, so those are all my thoughts on HyperOS 2.0. Let me know in the comments what you thought of this update and if you already made the update on your phone. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.